Macho Man! We are brought to you by Yes, Myoplex, Polar, Hoka, One One, Velofix, Normatec, Four Seasons Hualalai, where we are the lovely hosts for our championship edition, MEO Power Breather, the woman who made the race yesterday, Lucy Charles. How about a round of applause for our silver medalist from yesterday? Love that. So, Lucy, it takes, when you got someone like Daniela Reif, who's won this thing the last couple years, to potentially take her out of the comfort zone, but also, more importantly, there's a lot of other people behind, and your strength, one of your strengths, is being a great swimmer. What the plan was, go as hard as you can, because this is your first time, right?
Yeah, so, obviously, yeah, it's my first time here, and it was kind of go for it from the start, really. You haven't got anything to lose. And
nothing.
Yeah, let's see how much of a gap we can get on the swim and go with it. And, yeah, it definitely paid off.
Now, Lauren Brandon, also a great swimmer. We were just up at Mont Tremblant, and she swam through the entire men's field that started 3 minutes earlier. So when you guys got out of the water, you're pretty close together. Were you able to work together a little bit?
So I'd say, yeah, we definitely worked together in the swim, and that really, really helped. And then we biked away together and somehow was making a gap on the other girls, which I didn't expect to happen. So, yeah, we were just clinging on and seeing what we could do. And, yeah, we were actually gaining time.
And there was a point where Danny was 5 minutes back, and we're thinking, she's going to make up something. She got it down to three something, then it went back up to five. Were you getting splits to know where she was at?
Yeah, so we were getting splits along the way, and like when the first one came in and we'd actually gained time, I was like, is this a mistake? Like,
yes.
Is something wrong here? So, or I thought she might have had a puncture or something.
Sure.
I wasn't sure. So, yeah, that was a really nice surprise to see that we were actually gaining time. And then the gap kind of didn't really seem to change much. It was just staying the same. So I knew that we were riding well, and we must have been riding strong to maintain that.
So you did a lot of training in Lanzarote. And this is sort of like that, right, in terms of just the wind and the heat. Did you feel that worked for you, that all the your training base?
Yeah, 100%. I mean, normally in March I'll do a four-week block out in Lanzarote at Club La Santa, and I always find that I really, really benefit from that. So I knew that this was going to be 8 weeks, so it was double the amount of time, and I was really hoping that was going to come through and show something and show that my biking had really improved. And thankfully, I think the 8 weeks of hard work really, really did come through.
What were your impressions of this island and this race?
I mean, even though racing Ironman Lanzarote is such a tough course, just because of the climate and the conditions of this race, it is just relentless. It is so, so tough. And if you do overbike, then the chances of falling apart on the run are almost like 90 to 100%. So it was a gamble to ride as hard as I did. And I really did expect to fall apart on the run. I thought I'd overbiked, and I felt I was really lucky to hang on that run.
307.
Yeah, so
you had to be impressed with that.
Yeah, I mean, off the bike in Frankfurt, I ran a 3:13, which was my quickest ever run off the bike. And to come to this island with these conditions to actually run like 5 minutes into my best time was a real surprise. I did not expect to do that. So, yeah, it's great to see that the run is improving as well.
When you see Sarah Crowley back there, who ran by you in Frankfurt,
yeah,
were you a little concerned that she's coming?
Yeah, I mean, obviously, I knew Heather was there as well,
yes,
and Sarah, and they were having a battle like between themselves, so I knew they were going to be pushing, and I did expect to end up off the podium
yes,
when I saw them girls, and yeah, I just had to really, really stay strong and just keep pushing all the way to the end and looking over my shoulder to see if they were coming, and it wasn't until I was back on Alley Drive that I could have a little look behind my shoulder and know that I'd got second place and I could actually enjoy coming into that finish line.
What did that mean to you, getting second place, your first time here, Ironman World Championship, the most important event in the sport?
Yeah, I don't think I can put it into words, really, and it definitely hasn't sunk in. It's just, I've been saying you're probably not going to wipe the smile off my face for a good few weeks. But yeah, I mean, if anyone was at the finish line watching, they could see the emotion. It was just overwhelming. And then to have Chrissy Wellington there as well was just, I've never actually met Chrissy.
You hadn't met her before?
No. So, and she's an absolute hero of mine. And to have her there at that moment was so special.
Well, and just like she won the first time out, you get second first time out. There's a lot of a learning curve for this event that you sort of just shattered. What was the toughest part for you? Did you have some downs?
I mean, there's always dark patches in any Ironman. It's such a long day, and you have to keep yourself positive when you've got them negative thoughts coming in. And there's always really dark patches on the bike when you start to see your power dropping off slightly, and then you try and bring it back up when you're feeling so tired, and you start to feel a bit sick, and you're thinking, is my nutrition working? And you know that you're really going to find out on the run if it has worked or not. And luckily the nutrition plan really did work, and I actually got on the run and felt pretty strong, but I just wanted to stay relaxed. So, all round, it was just a dream day.
So when you head back to, now we'd be based in England during the winter. And have you already been hearing from some media that, hey, we'd like to chat with you when you get home?
Yeah, I think my phone pretty much blew up after the race. So
I was guessing that might happen.
And my following has definitely increased on all my social media platforms.
Is it really? Everything?
Yeah, so everything has been really crazy. And like the emails coming in, and all the friends and family at home who are just overwhelmed by what I've done. And they can't wait to celebrate with us when we get home, which we can't wait to do either, because we've just been disciplined all year. Since January I've been racing. And
no discipline anymore.
So I think we'll let our hair down for at least a week or two, and then we'll get back to work.
So in 2012, trying to make it to London. You're trying for 800 meters. You're trying at the 10K open water swim, and then that leads to triathlon. Could you have imagined that 5 years later you would be on the podium in silver medal at the Ironman World Championship, based on where you were at then?
No, I mean, the thing was, I signed up for Ironman and triathlon just to change what I was doing and have a bit of fun, because swimming had kind of really taken a dark turn and it just wasn't fun anymore. And it's always been about having fun for me, whatever sport I've been doing. So that was the main thing, was just to have fun. And I didn't expect it to become kind of my career at all. So, it's been a real whirlwind few years.
And it's still fun.
There's definitely moments in that Ironman when you think, why the hell have I picked this to do?
But then you remember back to 100,000 yards a week.
So as tough as Ironman is, I still love that there's the variety there, and it's a lot more exciting than following the black line in the pool. So I think I'm going to be sticking with it.
When you do what you did yesterday, and also this year with winning Lanzarote, you've had an amazing year. Put yourself on the map very quickly. Obviously, next year you'll be marked. People will be going, okay, this is somebody we need to watch. I'm guessing you look forward to that.
Yeah, I mean, definitely. And I would say, coming into this race, that I definitely didn't expect to finish where I did, because I know that there's still so much more in me and so much more I've got to give. So I still feel there's so much improving to do. And even small things, like there's no way I'm mounting a bike how you should mount a bike. I know it's not really important in an Ironman, but it's seconds at the end of the day. So even small things, I think there's so much I can take away and learn and improve. So I'll be up in my game for next year anyway. So I can't wait to come back and give it another shot.
That's a little scary. She'll be upping her game. How about a round of applause for Lucy Charles Pachovan? Take us out.
Guys with diamonds and silver, and preface with Pachovan.